Read something in a book and it just makes you go, whoa. Well, I just kind of had that experience reading Midnight's Children by Salman Rushdie. And this is taken from the chapter TikTok, which is the last chapter in part one of the book. You need to realize that this entire statement is actually one massive run-on sentence, which is really quite impressive when you think about it, given that English is kind of my thing and we usually tend to avoid the ROS as much as humanly possible. But get a load of this. I think maybe, just maybe, you will agree that it is absolutely mind-blowing. Or maybe I'm just a weirdo. I wouldn't be surprised if I'm just a weirdo. Hurtling on, I paused to pick up the game of hit the spittoon. 5 years before the birth of a nation, my inheritance grows to include an optimism disease which would flare up again in my own time, and cracks in the earth which will be have been reborn in my skin. And ex-conjurer hummingbirds who began the long line of street entertainers, which has run parallel with my life, and my grandmother's moles like witch nipples and hatred of photographs and what's its name, and wars of starvation and silence, and the wisdom of my Aunt Aliyah which turned into spinsterhood and bitterness, and finally burst out in deadly revenge, and the love of Emerald and Zulfikar which would enable me to start a revolution. And crescent knives, fatal moons echoed by my mother's love name for me, her innocent Chandka Tukra, her affectionate piece of the growing larger now, floating in the amniotic fluid of the past. I feed on a hum that rose higher, higher, until dogs came to the rescue, on an escape into a cornfield and a rescue by Rashid, the rickshaw walla with his guy walla antics as he ran. Full tilt, screaming silently as he revealed the secrets of locks made in India and brought Nadir Khan into a toilet containing a washing chest. Yes, I'm getting heavier by the second, fattening up on washing chests and the under-the-carpet love of Mumtaz and the rhymeless bard, plumping out as I swallow Zulfikar's dream. My bath by his bedside in an underground Taj Mahal and a silver spittoon encrusted with lapis lazuli. A marriage disintegrates and feeds me. An ant runs traitorously through Agra streets without her honor, and that feeds me too. And now false starts are over, and Amina has stopped being Mumtaz, and Ahmed Sinai has become, in a sense, her father as well as her husband. My inheritance includes this gift. The gift of inventing new parents for myself whenever necessary. The power of giving birth to fathers and mothers, which Ahmed wanted and never had. I had to reread that a few times. Holy crap. If you want to know exactly where it is in this copy of the book anyway, it starts at the bottom of page 119 and runs about two-thirds of the way through page 120. Wow. So once again, chapter TikTok, the last chapter in part one of Midnight's Children by Salman Rushdie. I'll let you know if there's anything else as this.